This is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of the day. We start with the news on Attukal Pongala festival. Thousands of women took part in the ritual in Thiruvananthapuram today, ignoring the intense summer heat. Kerala High Court has expressed concerns about smoke rising from Brahmapuram dumping yard's fire incident, strictly instructs officials to solve waste management by June 6th. Conrad Sangma takes oath as Meghalaya's CM for the second time, while nephew Rio sworn in as Nagaland CM for the fifth term. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan's aide CM Ravindran quizzed by Enforcement Directorate today. 10 killed in landslides in Indonesia and more than 40 feared missing. Let's get into the details. Millions of devotees, a vast majority of them women, occupied the streets of Kerala capital Thiruvananthapuram today to offer Pongala for goddess Attukal Bhagavathi. The Attukal Pongala is marked as the largest annual gathering of women by the Guinness Book of World Records. The ritual began around 10:30 a.m. when the Pandara Adupa, or the main hearth on the temple premises, was lit and went on till the afternoon. Around 300 priests blessed the Pongala offerings by the devotees, whose hearth line extended to more than 10 kilometers from the temple premises despite the extreme summer heat. The Kerala High Court asked Ernakulam District Collector, Pollution Control Board Chairman and the Corporation Secretary whether the fire at the Brahmapuram waste dumping yard was man-made. While the Pollution Control Board Chairman struggled to give proper answers, the District Collector did not appear in court and deputed the officer in charge of disaster management instead. The court asked the officials what steps were taken against those throwing waste away carelessly, and the officials replied that CCTV cameras have been installed to identify the offenders. The court, which expressed displeasure over the collector's absence, said that a proper solution for the waste issue should be arrived at by June 6th. If clear answers are not given to the questions asked in court, punitive actions would be taken for the same as well, the court added. The fire at the Brahmapuram waste yard started last Thursday and it took the officials 5 days to put it out. However, Kochi is still filled with the residue smoke and the court said the city feels like a gas chamber now. Meanwhile, the government also formed a high-level committee to investigate the incident. Conrad Sangma, the leader of the National People's Party, was sworn in as Meghalaya's chief minister for the second time today. Meanwhile, in Nagaland, NDPP leader nephew Rio also took oath as the CM for the fifth term. PM Narendra Modi also took part in Rio's swearing-in ceremony. The votes in both the states were counted on March 2nd after the elections in February. Before we move on, here is a quick reminder to check out On Manorama's other podcasts, Extra Time, Wacky News and Newsbreak. Extra Time is all about what's happening in the world of football, your favorite players and more. Wacky News is a collection of the weirdest and strangest news from across the globe, and Newsbreak is a clutter-free explainer of the major news story of the week. The programs are available on all podcast platforms. Now, back to Daily News Dose. CM Ravindran, the additional private secretary to the Kerala Chief Minister, appeared before the Enforcement Directorate office in Kochi on Tuesday morning for questioning in the Life Mission graft case. He did not appear before the ED on the first date given to him, which was February 27th. Ravindran is to be questioned to get more details on his relationship with former UAE consulate employee Swapna Suresh and UNITAC owner Santosh Eapen and the deals between them in connection with the case. After torrential rains triggered two landslides in Indonesia's Natuna Regency recently, disaster officials said they are still searching for 42 people who are feared missing on Tuesday. As per reports, they are trapped in 27 houses that were buried under tons of mud from surrounding hills. Natuna's disaster agency lowered the death toll Tuesday morning to 10 from 11 despite fears it could rise. The landslides displaced more than 1,200 people who were evacuated from the Regency. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.